We are facing a plastic pandemic on land and in the sea. Plastic poses a devastating threat to marine life, entangling animals, transporting invasive species, and allowing toxins to accumulate in the food chain. That's where we come in.
Thanks. Our team has been working to create an inventory of technologies that function to either prevent plastic leakage into marine and riverine environments or remove plastic pollution from waterways. This inventory is a streamlined tool that researchers and governments can use to learn about the options available for plastic pollution remediation. Here you go, Emma.
Thanks. This inventory also allows us to make comparisons between the scope of solutions and the breadth and severity of the plastic pollution problem, and identify the strengths and weaknesses of current technological approaches. We hope that innovators and policymakers will be able to use this inventory to determine how best to target future innovation efforts to complement the existing efforts. Here you go, Bea.
I'm working on the health portion of the project. So I'm investigating how plastic pollution affects the health of mammalian cells to emphasize the need for our plastic bioremediation technology. I found evidence that PET itself is not harmful to cells, but when plastic is treated with toxins such as metal stearates, it adsorbs those toxins and carries harmful toxins to the cells. I am now researching how toxins from harmful algal blooms and oil spills interact with PET and polystyrene, so we can understand how a wide range of marine toxins interact with plastic. Hey, Melanie.
Polyethylene terephthalate, or PET, is the most common form of plastic. In 2016, scientists discovered that the bacteria Idionella sacaensis secretes an enzyme called PETase, which is capable of breaking down PET. Unfortunately, PETase needs to be optimized to be capable of degrading PET efficiently. Hey, Justin.
I'm working on a better way to measure PET activity. Currently, PET activity is tracked by measuring terephthalic acid, or TPA, using slow methods like high-performance liquid chromatography or mass spectrometry. This past semester, I've tested a fluorescence assay that's able to detect PET degradation by Idionella sacaensis, allowing us to speed up the discovery and characterization of future PETases. Hey, Yiwei.
Thanks. I'm working on integrating expression system into a hyperthermophilic bacterium, allowing it to produce an enzyme that binds and utilizes PET building blocks above its gloss transition temperature. This system will improve biodegradation efficiency. Hi, Ella.
Last year, we generated a library of mutant PETase sequences through random mutagenesis in the hopes of creating a more efficient version of PETase. Once we optimize a system to express PETase, the mutant PETase sequences will be transformed into E. coli and subjected to directed evolution, allowing us to identify any mutant PETase with an enhanced ability to degrade plastic. Hey, Sarah.
Directed mutagenesis is another PETase optimization method. By using the CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing system and Evolver, I'm trying to create a library of mutant versions of the PETase gene. Some of these mutants may create a more efficient version of PETase, allowing the enzyme to better degrade thick crystalline PET. Hey, Zack!
My portion of the project focuses on large-scale searches for proteins similar to PETase and MetaSE in already existing protein databases through different alignments and organismal comparisons with PETase-like and MetaSE-like proteins. I am analyzing the evolution of PETase and MetaSE. Hey, Serafina.
Hey, Zack. I'm comparing different protein sequences to PETase and MetaSE to guess if they have the same functional ability to degrade plastic. Hey, Sophie.
Our mission goes beyond tackling plastic pollution. We're paving the way for governments and researchers to have the information and means to take action. This is our promise to you, a world that conserves the ocean's vast biodiversity and health so that every animal can swim freely on our beautiful planet.